Okay, YouTube friends, so as you can see here, I got the sawmill up on some bunks. I got a 12-foot fir log over there on the forklift, so thought I might show you the new loading operation with that. I think that's about 12.6. I'll double check the length, and then it has the end where I bucked it off the root ball that I'll clean up, assuming I have the room. So I'll get to that. Oh, okay, I grabbed that one just slightly off center, but I sat there scooting it back and forth. I need to remember to move that clamp because I bump into the T-handle, but it wouldn't quite line up bunk to bunk, so I split the difference here on how much overhang on each bunk, because I found that if I level it up on one bunk, it's like the other end gets pushed down. It's kind of funky. Surprised that that thick of wood would do that, but anyhow, it seems to. So now it's just a matter of clamping her down and sawing it and roll it with the PB. So let's get her clamped. Could have took a thicker slab, but kind of liking doing some little projects with this live edge wood. So I'm going a little thinner, and then I'll take a couple live edge boards off of it. Yeah, I've been doing some other milling this morning. I think that blade's just about had it, so change that thing out. And I just, these are the first big ones I've milled since I put these beams on it, and I know I bumped it harder than I meant to with the forklift, but looks like I got a little settling on a post up there and some right in here, so I'll have to do a little re-leveling. Over here. See, it's wanting to roll back and it shouldn't be. It wasn't at the beginning of the day. Yeah. See. Yeah. That blade's dulled up a bit. Want to bring me the torque wrench, please? Give it a spin like that. Tracks right back on. Check this belt here. Oh well. That might actually been more so the issue. That belt's super loose, so we will get that tightened up. So you want to see the super helpers here? Here we go. Say hi, girls. So we'll get the belt tightened up and get back to it.